Hi guys, Hubs here. This episode I'm going to be doing a little bit of an instance run, going to be doing some in-between, and I'm going to end it with some PvP and some traditional Hobbs way of pulling. This is my first time in ZA. You've been following my guild for the last few months, a lot of you. We've been progressing through Kara, we've been doing some mags, we've been doing some gruels. Been growing together as a guild, because as you know, one of the strategies to gear up is to, you know, leave guild, go to a stronger guild, then leave there, go to a stronger one. But we have been growing together, which is a little bit slower of a process, but in the long run it's going to be a better process, because you know the people that you're playing with, and you know every time a drop comes, it comes for the guild. We got about 9 in the guild here. I think we had to pug one. And ZA is great so far. It's all area effect and crowd control, everything I love. Well, this part, as you can see, is area effect, but as we're going to be clearing up to the bear boss, as you clear up, there is some crowd control where the two tanks pull the bears with the riders on them away from each other so that they don't give each other buffs and get more damage. And then as you get to here, the first boss, he's going to be in troll form and bear form. And with the two tanks, you want to tank him back and forth, pulling aggro from one another during the whole process. The reason being is that the troll actually does have a debuff that will increase bleed effects. And then the bear has a bleed effect. So if you have them both on you, you're going to die, and you're going to die fast. The other thing too with the bear is he will stun the entire party for 2 seconds. It's nice to have a heal over time during this stun, because he's going to be hitting you with a lot of damage. And the other thing is, he does have this swipe that will hit both tanks, and it can be, I think, up to approximately 30,000k. So, but the nice thing is with two tanks is it will be divided between the two of them. What I did while I was tanking, when I was doing the bear, I threw wisdom on him to try to drop my aggro down and help the warrior build the aggro. And then when I have a deadly boss mod now, when it said, you know, that he's going to be changing, then I would use my aggro taunting effects to pull him towards me, and of course the warrior would reduce his aggro with whatever warriors do. The other thing too, of course, if you do have the bleed effect on you, I talked about this in the Morose video, you can actually get rid of it with a couple things like Stone Form or Blessing of Protection. I actually made this macro with Blessing Protection that I used during the Nightbane fight when we didn't have anybody to control the fear. Now, of course, you can only use a Blessing Protection every few minutes, but it would just be, you'd click it twice and it would put the bubble on you, and then it would debubble you right away as well. So I can also use that here with this boss. It is a long fight, so you can use it a few times to remove the bleed effect. But you want to make sure you hit it quick, because you don't want to lose aggro. One thing you'll notice too when he's in troll form is he will charge random party members, just like Adamin in Kara, the first boss. So, you know, it's not that you're losing aggro, it's just that he'll do a random charge from time to time. The tanking him back and forth and got him killed, and you know, touched on a lot of little things. There's a couple other things you can read up online, like, you know, mages can use amplified magic because there's no magic abilities here. I'll have links on my wowhobs.blogspot.com for a full read up. Our pally got, who I like to call Wooden Face now, because, I mean, that's quite the interesting helmet he got, but it's going to help him heal better. Going to show you a little bit of the pets that came on the last Children's Week, which was an orphanage event that Blizzard held, where you could get a random pet. I ended up getting this crazy bird that runs all around and is out of control, and it's probably the last thing I need. I like order in my parties, and this guy's the furthest away thing from order. You'll notice the little one-eyed Willy here of Tinker Gigs. He zaps random low-level creatures from time to time, which is quite interesting. Once in a while you'll see him fall asleep, So we took some footage there of both the pets so you could see. Next year I'll probably get that Willie versus this bird who runs all around. There he is sleeping. The reason why we took him to Deep Run Tram is there's always lots of rats around. And of course the other pet you could get during that week was the elephant, which I believe just kind of stands on its hind two legs from time to time. Now, people are asking me a lot in my chat, do you ever run people? You don't do any more Hobbs Way of Pulling where you're power leveling people. I do still do it. I just don't make a video all the time that I've done it because I don't think you want to see, you know, repeats in Scarlet Monastery over and over, or a lot of the ones I've got Stratholme videos. I've got, you know, Black Foam Depths. This one, I was waiting for my party to come in. We have as low as level 27, I believe, and as high as, I think it was 30-something, 34 maybe. Maybe we had a 37, I don't know. We were going to do Cath, but of course, one of the level 33 rogues, undead rogues, saw me there. And I think he did a shout out to the horde who were in the area to come. So I have a level 70 chamois and a level 68 rogue. Now I wasn't too worried about the rogue. The chamois with the healing, and he's a lot like a pally where he's got lots of, he's got a shield, he's a protection. So, you know, we're going to bang on each other for a long time before anybody dies. I like to compare two prot pallies fighting almost like two guys hitting each other with a wet mop. You know, it's going to go on forever. That's why I have sped this up. But just so I can show the fight. We had a moment to when the rogue ran in, we had a moment to drink up and everything. And I got my Righteous Fury on because, as everybody knows, that's my Achilles heel. But then again, I did notice I didn't have a blessing on me either as well. Which I probably would have liked Blessing of Sanctuary or Blessing of Wisdom. But either way, the fight ended up going pretty decent. And hats off to this chamois because, I mean, he did an excellent job. You could tell he was mainly spec'd DPS or prod versus healing because it doesn't do a lot of healing up until the end. And this is a point where we're just, you know, one hand versus one hand and shield block and all this other stuff. It's just time to pull out the two-hander and get it down a little bit faster. Because, I mean, by this point, I'm annoyed. I just want to get my... I'm still waiting for my party, waiting to summon them in, get one person here. So, you know, and I don't really want to die for the simple fact that it's more inconvenient than anything. Like I said, a long fight. Thank goodness I sped this up. Hey, guys. Be like that Willy character, you'd be falling asleep. So now that we have a chance to summon everybody up, ready to go, I gave a bow to the other guy when he rez and we left each other alone, but this rogue just wouldn't stop, and now he's picking on my lower members, which I don't like. So gonna have a little bit more PvP footage. That's probably one of the most annoying things is when they do gank lower members. I know unless the lower member starts taunting or aggroing my guys, I normally just leave them alone. It's one, you're not going to get an honor kill usually. Of course, with this guy, he's pretty close within range if I do kill him, which, you know, rogues are usually probably the easiest for me to PvP. And I also want to reiterate, I'm not bragging that I am the best at PvP, because people know this isn't my game. I'm a PvE, and I like to just play the game for playing the game. I like to power level people. And look at that, it got absorbed again. It got absorbed earlier on the stairs, got absorbed now. Use the swiftness potion to do the catch up, hoping that I can just get this one little bit percent down as he mounts up. Bam. Nothing like a rogue running. That's why I carry a swiftness potion. So now I'm able to do what I do love best is power leveling. That's a few reasons why I've been getting different gear, but now I'm doing higher instances. I'm going to talk a little bit more on the Hobbs Way of Pulling on the next video. Subscribe, guys, so you can see my next video, It's a little yellow button in the top right-hand corner.